पर्वतो नारद धम्म भगवान बादरायणः बृहद्वास भरद्वाज सशिष रेणुकासुत वैशिष्ठ इंद्र प्रमाद त्रितो गीतास्मदोस्थित कक्षीवान गौतम त्रिश्च कौशिक अथ सुदर्शन ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय पर्वतो नारद धम्म भगवान बादरायणः बृहद्वा बृहद्दश भरद्वाज शशिष रेणुकासुत वैशिष्ट इंद्र प्रमाद त्रितो घृतास्मदोस्थित कक्षीवान गौतम त्रिश्च कौशिकोत्थ सुदर्शन पर्वतो नारद धम्म भगवान बादरायणः बृहद्वाज भरद्वाज शशिष रेणुकासुत इष्टा इंद्र प्रमादास तो ग्रीष्मा सुरासिता शिवान गौतम त्रिशा शिकोदा सुदर्शन पर्वतो नारद धम्म भगवान बादरायण भद्रसो भरद्वाज शशिष रेणुकासुत वैशिष्ट इंद्र प्रमाद स्थितो गृत्स मदोपस्थित कक्षीवान गौतम त्रिश्च सुदर्शन प्रतो नारद धम्म भगवान बादरायण यतेशो भरद्वाज शशिष्ठ रेणुकासुत वैशिष्ट इंद्र प्रमादास कपिष्ठ मदसुत So we're going to, we did word to word meaning yesterday. We'll just read the translation and then we'll begin with this. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. All the sages like Parvat Muni, Narada, Dhamma, Vyasa, the incarnation of God, Brihadasya, Bharadvaja, and Parashuram, and disciples, Vasishta, Indrapramat, Trita, Gritashmada, Ashita, Kakshiban, Gautama, Atri, Kaushika, and Sudarshana are present. These are the names of all the incarnations. Om Jnanati Mirandhasa Jnananjana Salakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Jena Tasmai Sri Guruve Nama Sri Chaitanya Mano Vistam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale Sayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Shapadantikam Vandeham Sri Guru Sri Juta Pada Kamalam Sri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Sri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanitam Tam Sajivam Sadaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Sri Vishakanitamscha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Simate Bhakti Vedanta Swamini Tinamine Namaste Sarasvati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sunnavadi Paschata Desha Tarine Bancha Kalpa Taruvesha Kripa Sindhubhaye Pacham Patitanam Pavonaibho Vaishnavibho Namo Namo Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityanandam Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in Chaitanya Charitamrita, explained to Sanatana Goswami Pada, what is the intention, purpose of all these incarnations? Next few slokas, you will see so many names of great personalities. Shaktavesh Avatar, Vishnu Avatar. What is the need of all? Why not just one? The demigods are already appointed officers. They can be empowered more to kill the demon. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave the beautiful understanding to Sanatana Goswami Pada in Madhva Lila, Chaitanya Charitamrita, chapter 20. Avatar hai Krishna sadvid vikar, prakar. Purusha avatar ek, lila avatar are. Guna avatar or Mannantar avatar, Juga avatar or Shaktavesh avatar. This is a very confidential understanding of that before Mahaprabhu came, no scriptures, no acharya explains the hidden meaning of different incarnation. All these names that today reading, they are all Shakta Vaishavatar mostly. And Vishnu Avatar, in the next few sloka you will see the speaker, they will be speaking about different personality. So in Adilila chapter 6, text 111, Avatar Bhakta Bhav Adhikar Iha Hoite Adhik Sukh Nahiha. Avatar Ganesha Bhakta Bhave Adhikar. All the incarnation has a rightful eligibility or ownership, you can say, to relish the due respect and opulence that as a god they have. But Mahaprabhu says, Avatar Ganesha Bhakta Bhav Adhikar, Bhakta Bhav Hoite Adhik Sukha Nahiya. But what is the purpose to become God or incarnate or empowered incarnation? What is the purpose? Because if we look at for power, what is the ultimate purpose of power? In the material world, Prabhupada writes, many, many sloka he writes, that the moment the soul comes in contact with this material world and he Rajagun takes his love for God, transform it into lust, and then you are sitting in a vehicle, Haribol, journey began, you will never be satisfied. But how do you do it? Only two ways. You want to control and lord it over. Why? Well, what is the purpose? Why we are here, even for any reason? Happiness, to enjoy. As a simple way, Prabhupada said to the reporter when in England, when the reporter asked what's the purpose of life, Prabhupada said, to enjoy. That's it. He's quiet. The reporter didn't have any other question. So it is to enjoy. So as a this sloka is such a hidden, almost no acharya ever mentioned this until Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, that the purpose of God or all his incarnation or anybody or anything to enjoy happiness. Adhik sukha nahiya. Even God cannot enjoy ultimate concept of God as a God, supreme controller, supreme absolute truth, ontological truth, existential power. You can go on, omnisciency, omnipotent, go on list. But what's the purpose? To remain happy, more happy, more happy. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in his previous incarnation as Krishna in chapter 4 Adilila, he explained, Vishaye jatiya sukh amar asad, amahoite koti gun ashrayer allad. Ashray jatiya sukh paite man dhai, jatne asadite nari ki kori upai. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Srila Prabhupada gave a beautiful purport, chapter 4. The Vishaye jatiya sukh amar asad. I have a right to enjoy as Krishna, but when to taste my own happiness, what's the difference between Radharani and Krishna? Krishna is the embodiment of rasa. Radharani is not an embodiment of rasa. Radharani is the embodiment of prema, love. This subject and subjective, object and objective eternally existing. Radha Krishna Vaiche Sada Eki Swarup. One ontological truth has a two form. Not that there is a two God. There is no two God. Radha Krishna are not two God. The one God has a two form. Radha Krishna Vaiche Sada Eki Swarup. Lila Ras Asadite Dhare Dui Rup. Lila Ras Asadite. to relish this increasing happiness, they took these two forms. And there's a famous verse also to establish that point, 1.1.5. Radha pranaya mahima kidrisha bana eva. No, sorry. Radha krishna pranaya vikriti ladini shakti asmad ekatmana bhupi pura deha vedam gato to. Ekatmana, they are one, ontological truth, one, ekatmana, bhubi, deho bhedam, now they have a one personality to two body, deho bhedam, divided into two body. So Radha Krishna are both are one, but Radharani is the embodiment of love, but she is not an embodiment of sweetness. Embodiment of madhur is Krishna. So there is a constant, irresistible attraction for each other. And it's very nice, teachings of Lord Chaitanya Prabhupada writes, this is the original root cause of everything. Why you are sitting here, why we live in Alachua, why the material world exists. Any question, anywhere, it's all from there. Just to increase this rasa, the experience. When you think of the apple, what attracts the apple? Is it the name or is it the color? It's the taste. It is not the name, not the color. From that angle you can look why bhakti is the ultimate. For any intelligent person can grasp it. Yes, if the taste is the attraction, not the name, not the color of the apple, then what is the taste? It's the bhakti. Bhakti and bhakti rasa. Prabhupada gave the society name Krishna Consciousness. And Mother Muikya read this, I think, 5-6 years back on Prabhupada's arrival day. And I still have it. It's very sweet explanation to Akshayananda Maharaj, who asked Prabhupada, why did you name Krishna Consciousness? Krishna Consciousness means it's not bhakti, it is bhakti rasa. And Prabhupada told him in Bombay, he says, Krishna bhakti rasa bhavita mati kriyatam jodi kutopi labbate. Only one thing we need in life, a greed to get that bhakti rasa. So in a short, if you ask like, what is the difference between bhakti and bhakti rasa? Mother Yashoda is offering the bhoga every day to Narayan. They have a Narayan Shila. Even Krishna come and bow down. On his birthday, he offer laddu to Narayan, to God. Why Krishna does this? Why everybody does this? To show what is bhakti. But what is bhakti rasa? He's experiencing. When he's hungry, he's not waiting for Narayan Prasadam. He wants breast milk. That is bhakti rasa. When devotee lovingly serving, when Krishna comes, tell Uncle Sunanda, the Upananda is the older brother, Nanda Maharaj is the middle, and then there are five brothers total. And Nandan is the youngest. Krishna grabs his neck and says, I can't live without you, I miss you, you have so much fun together. So like whenever they have a problem of whether Krishna is God, and says, he's not God, he lives by my embracing and wrestling with him. How can he be God? God doesn't need all this. So it's a good logic. So these are called bhakti rasa. It is not possible, actually, even theological, or even you can say devotional tradition, like all these four sampradaya, cannot understand this. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur gives an analogy. He says, just like a lotus flower, it has an origin coming in a stem. This is called Satyayuga lifestyle. You want a peaceful life? Go back to Satyayuga, you'll see the lotus stem, that's all. You'll never see lotus flower. It's very good analogy. This is very inspiring. The lotus stem, when you see, you'll think lotus flower will come someday. But you'll never see in Satyayuga lifestyle. Everybody's peaceful, horrible, nice life. Nobody lies, nobody steals, nobody's like, everybody's like a gentle religion or whatever. I lost the taste of it after you hear all this explanation. Who cares? It's nice, everything is peaceful, you know, no crime, nothing, problem. Who cares? But what are you getting out of it? Death is still coming. So then Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes, when Vyasadeva came, then the lotus stem started a budding form. Vyasadeva wrote all the scriptures like a budding form. I said, wow, that sounds exciting, at least. But what is inside the budding form, we don't know. Then the four acharya comes, they started opening the petal. When Mahaprabhu came, blossomed the lotus. All the fragrance, the real attraction for the bees. We have to become like a bees. Rupa Goswami Pad wrote a song, but Prabhupada put this in a purport. Krishna Deva Bhavantam Bande Manamanasa Madhukara Arpaya Nida Pada Pankaja Makarande Krishna Deva Bhavantam Bande. Rupa Goswami Pad wrote this, and Prabhupada put this in the purport of a Bhagavatam. Beautiful. That how our mind should be hooked for tasting that rasa. So, Parashuram, what is his purpose for rasa? They are looking for bhakti rasa. Radharani is the only person you can say, because there is a verse, Sei Premo Dware Nitya Radhika Ekoli. This is in chapter 4, Adilila, those who are curious where it's from. Amar Madhurjo Premo Asade Sakali. Krishna himself declared, he says, Radharani is alone drinking my 100% of all my sweetness. How many sweetness Krishna has? Four. Prema Madhuri, Lila Madhuri, Rupa Madhuri, and Benu Madhuri. This sweetness, this four sweetness, is such an unlimited ocean of nectar, sweet, that Radharani alone is drinking. And I like the way Prabhupada put it. Who is intimate to Radharani? Who? Rupa Manjari, Rupa Goswami, the Goswami, six Goswamis. Prabhupada put that in the beginning of teachings of Lord Chaitanya. So who is close to these six Goswamis? Who? Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami. Who is close to Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami? Narottam Das Thakur. Who is close to Narottam Das Thakur? Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. Who is close to Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur? Baladev Vidyabhusan. Who is close to Baladev Vidyabhusan? Jagannath Das Babaji. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then Gaur Kishore Das Babaji, then Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur. Prabhupada stopped there. It's very interesting. You know, it reminded me of this Mataji. You all remember Sarva Bhavana Prabhu? He was here like 12 years back. He was in the Russian jail. So he was working for me. I just moved to Alachua. It's 2003 or 2004. He was here. So he was working. So I asked him how was his torture, you know, by the KGB. It was a nice story of one Mataji, Russian Mataji, who really got tortured by the KGB. It was so fascinating how her experience went. They could not do anything, even with him, they could not do anything. So they actually brought a ghost. The KGB really believes the black magic ghost. So they brought this lady, scary lady, to hunt her and stop chanting. So at one point, this is Sarvana Prabhu is explaining about that Mataji's experience. She saw this like a big black person like trying to hunt, you know, like grab her and do all this. But she started chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. For a while, but nothing is happening. That lady is really like grabbed her. And she's thinking, oh my God, what to do? Okay, Nishinga Devi, Namaste, Narasinghaya. Can you imagine? Yeah, I would do that probably. And still not working. And then she got a little scared. Then she remembers Prabhupada and she started chanting, Namo Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna. All of a sudden she felt like that lady just dropped. And she's like standing from far. So she's hearing the KGBs talking to this black ghost hunter lady. Said, do something. She said, I can never do anything to her. Why? Because you see that man, old man with the cane. Anybody is with his shelter, I lose power. I have nothing. This is Prabhupada's. Really, like I thought many times, like, wow. We should not just take shelter of holy name. We should take shelter of Prabhupada's holy name. So we chant holy name through Prabhupada's mercy. It is a holy name, but there has to be under guidance, shelter. Then it is effective. It's so effective. Even Bhaktivinoda, then I found so many verses backing this opinion. Prathamastu gurum pujya tathasyaiva mama archanam. Kurban siddhim abhapnati hi annata nishphalam bhavet. If you do not take prathamastu gurum pujya, if you do not take worship guru or take shelter of guru and you want to start chanting, you'll get the result very late. Must take shelter of guru before you chant, before you do any things. Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Harinam Chintamani, he put this. I recite this every day before I start also, because of those pastimes like scary. He says, Agre Guru Puja, Pare Krishna Pujan, Guru Deve Krishna Prasad Samarpan, Guru Aggaloya Sada Pujibe Jatane, Guru Smariya Krishna Bolive Badane. Very sweet, Harinam Chintamani gives. That if you remember Prabhupada, even if you have a present Ishkan Guru, but make sure you not only stop there, you chant Prabhupada's name. Because Prabhupada is already proven, direct connect with the Supreme Lord in an extent that everything else will disappear. Attack and defeat are not the same thing. Like we may get attacked, like I do get attacked. Attack means the mind will remind you so many things you can divert. But it is not defeat. So when we get attacked, we take shelter of Krishna, Prabhupada, then we see that we are not defeated. Attack is not a defeat, but generally a lot of devotee thinks like attack is like a, my God, I'm not advancing. No, no, attack is attack. Attack will be there until you die, this body. Prabhupada said that in London when this man introduced to Prabhupada and says he's not a Hare Krishna and he's not practicing anything, but he has no sense enjoyment, thriving, no gratifier. Prabhupada said he should go to doctor immediately. I said, why? He said, that's sickness. It's not normal. Normal human being means natural inclination for sense enjoyment. When you become devotee, advanced devotee, then sense enjoyment will not disturb you. But it will attack you. Attack doesn't mean you are defeated. You follow? Like this morning we read, what is it? All the time. Oh no, Varun Prabhu. It's very nice. Let's see if I can find. Is that verse 1.11.3. He thought it was 14. Now it's a 13. You look at the purport, Prabhupada says, very sweet, that the soul, oh, because we are talking about the Tatastha Jiva, and then he said, in the purport, Prabhupada writes, Tatastha Jiva, everybody understand Tatastha Jiva, where we come from? We do not come from spiritual chit potency or material external potency. We come from a Tatastha Jiva Shakti, period. And he said, I could not understand your explanation, it's like a very nice, but then when I read this purport, I said, oh, it's the same thing. So he read it many times. This morning he was telling me and he grasped it. It's very sweet. That Tatastha Jiva means we here are never existing by our own right. We are always under another potency. You are product of your own decision means you have a choice to be under internal potency or external potency. You follow? You cannot just say, well, you know, I don't care, I'll be by myself. No, that idea, that thinking is Maya, the external potency. But if you choose, that is a rightful free will, that I want to think of Krishna and I want to stay under pure devotee, Prabhupada, then it is internal potency. It's not possible any soul can exist by its own right. You are eternal. Your eternal doesn't mean your existential is by its own right. Shakti means you are always under another potency. And the verse Prabhupada gave is Anisha Jiva Rupena. Anisha Jiva Rupena means the soul pleasure seeking by nature but always under another potency. So you choose. And I choose Maya, that's why I'm here. When I choose internal potency, then I will be in spiritual world. But while I'm not in spiritual world, Prabhupada gives in the last verse of second chapter, Prabhupada said the spiritual world and the access to the spiritual world, devotional service, on the both are same absolute platform. So those who have access to devotional service, they are as good as to be in the spiritual world. I love that. I'm paraphrasing what Prabhupada says. It's such a wonderful purport. Such a wonderful purport of Bhagavad Gita. So that means when we are chanting, we are actually in the spiritual world, according to Prabhupada. We do not need to hanker, but what we need to hanker is that the intention, the mentality, the appreciation, attitude. Just like last few weeks we are talking about 640 million people got killed. So they got killed. How did they get killed? Well, Mayebo, Krishna says in 11:33, it's a very funny verse. I mean, I just laugh at it because you can chew that verse all the time. Tasmat uttishtata jaso labhasya. Krishna is telling Arjuna, he's actually praising him. You know, like sometimes I wonder, like when you glorify devotee, is that normal? We should not like be glorified. No, it is normal. Krishna is glorifying Arjuna, that look, you should jitta shatru, you should defeat the enemy and enjoy this kingdom and flourish the kingdom. It sounds like he's bribing him, like, you know, it's like bribing him, glorifying him. Come on, enjoy. And what about all these people? It says, purvam ete, nihita, purvam ete. I already put them into death. So what Bhishma Dev is doing, Dronacharya is doing, the disturbing Arjuna's mind. They are just like a statue standing, about to fall. You just get the arrow and bow and just shoot and they will just fall. They're just waiting for that. They're already dead, put into death by me. What more do you want? Well, what should I do then? Nimitta matra bhava sabbasachi. Because you are expert fighter, I want you to take all the credit and become my instrument. Okay? And Prabhupada writes in the purport, very interesting. He says that, he's bringing the reference on the 1860, Sabhava jena kunte nivadda sena karmana kattum nechasi jan mahat karishyasi avasopi tat. That we are born with a particular combination of modes of material nature. So Krishna is telling that you will be bound, compelled to act what you are pre-programmed to act. Can you imagine? It's like a pre-program. We don't have really choice. Only choice we have, we can use this for Krishna's service or Maya's service. That's all. How long you will be alive, it's already done. Like a movie, Prabhupada said, how long you will be alive. While you are alive, you can engage your life for Krishna or automatically it will be gone to Maya. Nothing in between. There is no third place. You are situated on the third place. Tasmin shandam tritiya sapna sthanam. Tasmin shandam tritiya sapna sthanam. You are situated in the third place called sapna sthan. And ubhasthane pashyanti idancha paralokasthanancha. You can see the spiritual world, spiritual destiny. You can see the material world, material destiny. Be honest, we all can see, no? If I do this, I'll go there. If I don't do this, I'll go there. So you are see, that verse is such a relevant. Tasmin sandam titiya sapna sthanam tishtan nete. You recite there when you join. Ubhasthane pashyanti idancha paralokasthanancha. And you can see your destiny both, and you decide. Haribol, you are on your own. Recently, I just put in something, article a little bit about, Prabhupada writes, about Draupadi's departure. Prabhupada writes, every one of us has to fly our own flight. Each of us, really, spiritually, you're flying your own flight. What about my wife, my husband, my children, all this? Really, unless you are out of the flight, you cannot really help. Out of the flight means you are minimum liberated. Minimum liberated. Spiritually, materially, nobody helps anybody. Everybody, they live in the same room, but this is the conduct of the Mayadevi. It's supposed to be like a Mother Nanda says in the Mahaprabhu actually originally said, in the river, all these straws, all these leaves and, you know, whatever, the debris like flowing. And sometimes they get together. Oh, Haribol, how are you? We are nice family. After a few minutes, you know, the water comes and they split. Some get stuck on the bank. They are called liberated, done. No more water. They are out. Sounds very scary. But that's what this life is. Come to this point, I had a parents. They left this world. I have no access where they are. Of course, I love my mother so much more than my father. I love both, but my mother is like... So I literally prayed to the Lord, whatever I have credit, please give her in case if she didn't go anywhere. She was a great devotee, but still. So like that, we see that Parashuram... I'm sorry, I didn't talk anything about Parashuram. I was going to the whole class I was supposed to plan for.
I was waiting for it.
But I'll just end with one little story of Parashuram because I didn't talk about it. Parashuram is such an incarnation. He comes and gives the rasa to the... I like the way Prabhupada said, when Parashuram saw Krishna, he immediately paid obeisances. When he saw Ram, what did he do? He challenged. He fought. So I'll give you one little story. One time, Mother Sunayana. Everybody knows Mother Sunayana? Sita Devi's mother. You generally don't hear. You hear about Janak Raj, father's name. But Mother Sunayana is very powerful. I read her story, her life. It's very powerful, not today. But at least Sunayana, when she saw 10,000 warriors of Sun Dynasty, because Lord Ram came in Sun Dynasty, and Krishna came in Moon Dynasty. So in Solar Dynasty, Mother Sunayana gave a speech. He said, what is wrong with this man? 10,000 one by one came and nobody could lift up this Hardhanu, the Shiva's bow. And she was like, not criticizing, but he was really like indirectly heavy. He said, what's wrong with all these guys? And all these 10,000, they're sitting, they're really shame, you know, like, they cannot lift up. But Sita Devi is so beautiful, so beautiful. Everybody wants her, but they cannot pass the exam to have her. That was like a trauma. So the next, everybody failed, 10,000 failed. So in the evening, Ravana found out, he came and he tried to do it. He didn't want to embarrass himself. He said, I'm going to practice this before I go there. So he went to practice. While he went to practice, he's very powerful. Ravana is very powerful. He put his hand like this and some or other he lifted up a little bit because he was a follower of Shiva. But then his finger got stuck. And he started screaming to take the finger out. He cannot pull the finger out. All these thousands of Kshatriya, king and prince, they had to come and just to help him. And he came and he ran and ran. It was such an embarrassment, you know, like Ravana. He didn't want to confront or see that he's a useless guy. But he was hiding in an outer space in the sky just to see if it is possible anybody can ever get this girl. She is so beautiful. So of course, at night, Lord Ram and Lakshman, their message, their duty to their guru, Vishwamitra, that they massage and put him to sleep, and then they go to sleep, and they have to wake up before he wakes up. This is the duty of a servant. So, such an ideal example. But that day morning, Ram did a one-time mistake in his entire life. He always respected all the ladies as a mother, except that day. In the morning, his guru said, the duty is, Lakshman has a duty to bring water and Ram has a duty to collect some flower. So Ram went to collect the flower. When he was collecting flower, he had a glimpse of his Sita Devi, not knowing who she is, and he was staring at her. And after a little while, he realized, oh my God, what am I doing? I'm staring at a girl. It's not my nature. How? And he felt so guilty. Immediately he packed some flower and went back, and it's like a horrible feeling in his heart. Anyway, there's a beautiful pastime actually happened that morning. Then finally they came to the arena where 10,000 prince is still standing, sitting comfortably. They all want to watch. Is there anybody has a possibility to actually win her hand? So these two young boy come with Vishwamitra. They are such attractive, adorable. You know, you feel like to give him a hug. The Ram is so beautiful. So beautiful, Lakshman. But then Mother Sunayana began. Some or other, you think the ladies are not in the front? Actually, she was in the front in the whole ceremony. She gave the speech. She said, I'm repeating same thing what I ended yesterday. That solar dynasty is supposed to be glorious, Ikshaku. What happened? All this great, great soul. And she named all of them in Ikshaku dynasty, you know, like Surya Bangsa. But I'm so disappointed that my daughter is unparalleled beauty, not even one Kshatriya has. And she went on, I wish Dasharatha Maharaj's son would be like a really strong. He's just such adorable, so handsome, beautiful. But what can he do? All these big, big Kshatriya there. Can you imagine an arena of 10,000 king and prince are sitting there and useless? It was like such a humiliation, and Mother Sunayana like a cutting throat of all of them, like with her speech. I mean, she's right. Well, she wants to have it. And then, of course, she accused her husband a little bit. My husband did such a hard task that all the Sun dynasty failed. And today is the last day, and I'm so disappointed. Lakshman just came out. Oh, mother, please do not speak like this. How dare you speak in front of my brother and me? We are the ruler of Sun dynasty, Surya Bangsa. I cannot let this talk ever humiliate us. And then everybody is looking at her. Lakshman is just a young boy, you know, very handsome, but his speech is like very heavy. And says, if my brother order, why only this? Haradhanu, I break this type of million like a toy. Everybody's paying attention. He's really joking. Like, how dare a young boy like talks like this? All these big could not do it. So finally, all of a sudden, Parashuram appeared. Just by seeing the Parashuram appeared, all the 10,000 just got up and started shivering. They're not even normal anymore. They're shivering. And Parashuram says, who has done this? Who has done this? And King Janaka has to answer because he's the host. And he's thinking, I went a little fast. Hold on. I'll come back. Then, in the meantime, Vishwamitra Guru, he was smiling. And he told Ram, why don't you just go and show this? Lift up this Haradhanu. Ram is like the look of a Prabhupada is like an innocent look with the intelligent, full intelligent awareness. Impact with full intelligent but innocent look. This is what we all need. That innocent means you are content, you are peaceful, you are happy, you don't need anything. That's how Ram is. So when the Ram got the order of his Guru, he came and touched the feet of Guru. And then he went, he just touched the Haradhanu. By the time he lifted up, he didn't even pull the string, it just broke. It made a sound, such a echo sound, that in, what is that place called in South India, where Parashuram was meditating, the echo sound from Janakpuri to there is about 2,000 miles or 2,000 kilometers, whatever. And he went in one run, came right in front of, and all 10,000 king and prince, they all got started shaking, and he, Parashuram, just challenging, and King Janaka didn't know what to say. Because if he say Ram did it, they will, of course Ram will be killed immediately. That's his understanding. So what to say? But he did it. There is a chance that he will marry Sita. This is wonderful. Everything will be over. But Parashuram in between. Somebody has to pacify Parashuram. Who is going to say anything? Nobody. Then Lakshman comes. He looks at Parashuram. Parashuram is a big figure with his axe. Parash. Parash means the axe. And he says, why are you bragging such a big deal? My brother is the origin supreme personality of Godhead. If he orders me, I can break the whole universe. Why only this bow? I can break millions of bow in one shot. Parashuram is thinking, who is this? Who is talking? He like some other Jogamaya is like covered. At one point, he thought, okay, let's have a challenge. You have a more thing to say? Lakshman say, yes, my brother did this. Even not my brother, even I can just break millions. My brother is the origin of all source of power. Then Parashuram pull out his Vishnu Dhanuk. Vishnu Dhanuk is more powerful than Haradhanuk. So Vishnu Dhanuk is only for test, that who has how much power, because it's the highest. Then when Ram was asked to do it, Ram pulled the string, really like pull hard. And then Parashuram understood, okay, he is my origin. Nobody has power to do this. Then Ram says, what would you like? If I release this, you have two options. Either you lose all your power or the world will be destroyed. Whatever you want. Then immediately Parashuram understood, he's my origin. He said, no, Prabhu. You have come to do Leela pastimes. Let the world get benefit of your pastime. Let me lose all the Kshatriya Vashikaran power. He was invested with those power. That power is withdrawn back. So then the arrow was loosened. From that day, Parashuram, even he met Kamsa, he met many great personalities, very mysterious, and some or other he withdrawn. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu even met him in on the way. This is in Madhya Lila chapter 9-20 verse. Explained that Mahaprabhu met him, he was a Brahmana form. He is also entering into the Shiva's heart in Anantashar temple near Udupi. If anybody goes there, Parashuram recite theirs. Because I was curious whether he comes to Alachua or not. Impossible. He will be one of those great personalities who live for a long time. So thank you for paying attention. And I did speak something about Parashuram. Thank you. Any question, comment? No?
There's no questions on the chat.
Okay. No question? Okay. Very good. Thank you, Prabhu. Srila Prabhupada ki